Good morning, students. Today we will discuss about the concept of intermediate code generation. The outline of this today's class is discuss about the phases of compilers, then after that intermediate code generation, then how we will represent that intermediate code, then after that three iterations code, then in that we have quarter pulse, triples, indirect pulse, and finally we will discuss about lab programs and triples. Okay. So first, what do you mean by intermediate code? So here, during the translation of a source program into object program, okay, that is object code for a target machine, a compiler may generate a middle level language. Okay, so that middle level language we will call it as an intermediate code. Suppose if this is the source program, it may be in C or C, higher level language, and the target program is in a lower level language, that intermediate representation it may be in assembly level language. Okay, so this intermediate representative code is nothing but a intermediate representation of a, during the translation, the source program is converted into object code. At that time, it may generate intermediate language code. That one we will call it as an intermediate code. Okay, so this is the end of phases of compiler. So in that we are discussing lexical analysis, syntax analysis, semantic analysis. So after semantic analysis, so these three things we will call it as a front end of compiler, and this intermediate code generation, code optimization, and code generation, finally these are nothing but a back end of the compiler. So in that back end, this is the intermediate code generation to be the first phase. Okay, so that is, this is the fourth phase of the compiler, intermediate code generation after lexical analysis, syntax analysis, and semantic analysis. Okay, the output of semantic analysis, that is output of that is syntax tree. Okay, so that one will be the input to the intermediate code generation. Okay, so this is the, in that fourth phase is the intermediate code generation in the compiler. Okay, so here how will represents the intermediate code? So here, this is, there are four commonly used intermediate code representations. There are three types. So using syntax tree and postfix notations and three address code. Okay, so the syntax tree, so we already discussed in previous class in fifth module. Okay, so that is, after that we'll have a postfix notations, that is conversion of, that is representing the infix expression to postfix expression. That is, then after that, this is the important thing, three address code. Okay, so we'll take one simple examples on syntax tree, postfix notations, and three address code. Okay, so what do you mean by syntax tree? We already know that the syntax tree is nothing but a, it is more than a condensed form of a parse tree. Okay, so that is, you know, the condensed form of, so that is compressed, it means only important things we are taking from the parse tree, that one we will call it as a syntax tree. The operators and keywords are nodes of the parse tree, are moved to their parents to chain of a single production, is replaced by a single links in the syntax tree. The internal nodes are operators and child nodes are the operands. So usually in syntax tree, so here that operators will be a parents node. Okay, so then operands will be the a child node. Okay, so suppose if you have taken this example, okay, x is equal to a plus b star c, so within the parenthesis y divided by a minus b star c. Okay, so then if you represent this one in a syntax tree, so that the, I already told that operators are the root of the nodes and the operands are the childs. So you can take this one. So here x is equal to, so here equal will becomes the root of the tree. So then left, that is left side we will have hex. So then right side this expressions. Okay, so this expression will be represented in a parse tree. So here a plus b star division is there. So this division becomes the root of that right subtree. Okay, so in that division, so one side is this expression and right side will be the this expression. Okay, so when you come to left side of this, so here we have a plus, so in that plus a plus b star c, so here we have plus will be the root, so left of that we will have a, and right of that plus we will have star, in that star we have operands b and c are the child of this. So like that here, so when you come to right of this division, so here we are, for this expression, Okay, so for this expression here we have, so minus becomes the root of this subtree, and here A becomes the left of left child, and here right child will be the star. Okay, star, and B and C are the child of this star. Okay, so here we are not using any grammars or non-terminals. So here we are using only operators and operands. That one we will call it as a syntax tree. We already derived n number of syntax trees. Okay, so next one is postfix notations. We already know that we have converted infix to postfix expression. Suppose if we have a infix expression a plus b, so that is we convert the postfix means the first operand comes after that operator. Okay, so that is the same thing. So we will take one example. Okay, so here suppose if we have a minus b star c plus d plus a minus b. So this is the infix expression. So when you convert this one into a postfix expression, so this one will be a minus b. So that one will be, so a b operands will come first, after that minus, and here c. So within the parenthesis is there c plus d. So that is c d plus, then after that we'll have a minus b. So here a b comes first, after that minus, then after that we will have, so based on the precedence of the operators, so we will convert that one to infix to postfix expression. So then after that here star and plus is there, so plus comes first, here a b minus, then after that plus comes here, then after that a star comes here. So based on the precedence we will convert infix to postfix expression. That is the another representation. So next, third one is important thing is three address code. Okay, so here a statement, what is the three address code? Okay, a statement involving no more than three references. Okay, so when you are writing a three address code, that statement should only three references. That way we will call it as three address code. So that is, in that three address code we have two operands and one operator, two for operands and one for result. Okay, so that one we will call it as a three address statements, two for operands and one for results. A sequence of three address statements is also known as three address code. Okay, three address statements we will call it as a three address code. The three address statements is one of the form x is equal to y operator z. So it means here x, y, z will have the address. These are the three memory locations. Sometimes a statement may contain less than three references also, but it is still also called a three address statement. Okay, so a statement, it may contain three or less than three. Okay, at that time also we will call it as a, that one is a three address code. For example, here we have a is equal to b plus c star d. See here, in that 1 2 3 4 4 operands are there. So but here according to that two operands and one result. So but here we have total four operands are there, so that's why it's not in the three address. When you convert this one to three address translation, okay, three address code, so here what we are doing, so here we will divide this expression into sub expression. Okay, so how we will divide this, c star will be first calculated. Okay, so that one c star will be calculated first, and that one will be stored in R1. Okay, so c star s will be multiplying, and that one will be stored in R1. Okay, so intermediate memory, that one will connect as a register. Okay, so here this c star will be calculated, and that one will be stored in R1. So then after that, that whatever result I am getting, that one will be added with b. So that is, so b plus R1, so that one will be stored in result R2. Okay, so then finally this whole thing result will be copied to A. So that is, whole thing is a result is available in R2, that one will be copied to A. Okay, so that one we will call it as a three address code. So it means we are converting maximum two operands and one result. Okay, so that one we will call it as a three address code. So here in three address code we are having two different forms of representation. Okay, a three address code has at most three address locations to calculate the expression, maximum three address locations. Okay, so here this three address code can be represented in two forms, that is one is quadruples and another one is triples. So in the triples we will have indirect triples. Okay, so then how we will represent this quadruples? What do you mean by quadruples? So here in quadruples, each instructions in a quadruples representation is divided into four fields. One is operator, another one is argument one, another one argument two, and result. So four things. That is, one is operator, another one is argument one, another one argument two, and result. Okay. For example, here we have taken same example. R1 is equal to C star D, R2 is equal to B plus R2, then R3 is equal to R1 plus R2, and R3 A is equal to R3. So here in this first expression, R1 is equal to C star D. So here star is the operator and C and D are argument on argument two, and R1 is the result. This is the representation of quadruples. Okay, so like that here in the second statement, so plus is the operator. Okay, so then B and R2 will be the arguments. Okay, B and R2, sorry, R1 this is. Okay, so B1, B that is R2 is equal to B plus R1. So that is B plus R1. So that one result will be stored in R2. Okay, so then R3 will be addition of R1 plus R2, that is R1, R2, argument 2, R1, R2, and argument 2 is R1. So when I add these two things, I will get R3. Okay, so then finally A is equal to R3. We already told that, so it may contains A less than 3 operands also. So here we have, that is result will be A. Okay, so result will be A, and this one will be R3. Argument 1 will be R3, and operator will be plus. Okay, so like that we will represent the quadruples. Okay, so now come to triples. So here in triples, quadruples it has four fields. In triples it has three fields. So one is for operator. Okay, so another one is argument one, another is argument two. Three things: operator, argument one, argument two. Yeah, so operator, argument one, argument two. So the same expression, how we will represent that one in triples? Okay, the result of respective subject expressions are denoted by the position of the expression. Okay, so it will be, the result will be represent by the position of the expression. So here first one is R0 is equal to C star D. Okay, so first one is R0 is equal to C star D. So here argument 1 is C, argument 2 is D. Okay, so we have added two things. Sorry, multiplication. So operator is multiplication. So that is C star D. So argument 1 is C, argument 2 is D, and operator is star. It is multiplied, and that result is stored in memory, you know, that is position of the expression. So position of the expression is 0th. So it means in 0th locations, the result is stored. Okay, so then I am adding that R1 is equal to B plus R0. So R0 is nothing but is memory location. Okay, so this is position of, that is position of the expression. So here 0th position will be added with B. So operator is plus. So 0th will be added with B. That result will be stored in R1. That is R1 is nothing but a memory location. Okay, so here that is nothing but a position of the expression. Okay, so now R2 is equal to R1 plus R0. So here R0, the result will be stored in R0, that will be a 0th position. And here this B plus R0 will be result is stored in R1, that is first position of that expression, that is 0th and plus we are adding, that operator will be plus. Okay, so this is the second position. The second position, that result is stored in the second position of that expression. So then R2 will be copied to A. So that is operator equal and argument is 2. So here the result of respective sub expressions are denoted by a position of the expression, the result only. So then argument 1, argument 2 and operator remain same. That result, that's all. Okay, result will be represent in the form of expression. Okay, that one we will call it as a triples. Then last one is indirect triples. So here indirect triples, what we are here position of the expressions or sub expressions we are using in triples to represent the result. So here in indirect triples, this representation is an enhancement over the triples representation. It uses pointers. See here, it uses the pointer instead of position to store the result. Okay, so pointer, that's why we are calling as indirect triples. This enables the optimizer to freely repositions the sub expression to produce an optimized code. So here in this triples, we are using a position of the expression. So here it will use a pointer instead of positions. That's why we are called as a indirect triples. We will take an example on this. Okay. So here in exams, they may ask translate the following expressions to quadruples, triples, and indirect triple. Okay, so this is the expression they have given. Okay, so A is equal to B into minus C plus B into this is nothing but a multiplication symbol and B into minus C. Okay, so here, so this is not in a triple form, triple address code. So we need to convert first one in triples. Okay, so here how will convert this one? So here this minus e, I am taking this is a minus e. So you don't have here two operators or two operands for this. Okay, so this is an unary operator that is u minus unary minus. Okay, so here c unary minus c. Okay, so minus that is unary minus, this is the c operand. So this one will be stored in t1. Okay, so then after that T2, that is B into minus C. Okay, so minus C is nothing but a T1. So here T2 is equal to B into T1. Okay, so B into T1. So this one we are taken. Then T3 is unary minus C. Okay, so this is the 3. Okay, and T4 is equal to B into T3. Okay, so here B into minus C and B into minus C. Okay, so two times we have taken. Okay, B into T3. So that one will be stored in T4. So then after that, okay, so after that, what we are doing here, then we need to add these two things, B into minus C plus B into minus C. So this one will be the T2. Okay, so whole thing will be the T2. And here it will be a T4. Okay, so I am adding T2 plus T4. Okay, so this is T2 and T4. So I am adding these two things and that one will be stored in T5. And finally, the T5 value is stored here. So this is the representation of three address port for the given expression. Okay, in exams, they may ask, they will give the expression and represents the three address code. So then you need to write this one. Then how we will represent that one in a quadruples? Okay, so same thing. So here in quadruples, we have four things, that is operator, argument one, argument two, and result. Okay, so this is the location. If you want, you can write it. Otherwise, this is for a quadruples, it will be enough. So here, so first one is T1 is U minus unary minus C. So here operator is minus U minus. Okay, argument is C and result will be stored in T1. Okay, so then T2 is equal to B into minus one. Okay, so T2 is equal to B into minus 1. So here B and T1 are the arguments. B and T1 are the arguments. And result is stored in T2. And this multiplication is the operator. Okay, multiplication is the operator. And B and T1 are the arguments. Okay, B and T1 are the arguments. And this is the T2. Result will be T2. So then T3 will be, okay, so unary minus C. Okay, so unary minus C, so the operator is the U minus and the argument one is C and result will be stored in T3. Okay, so then T4 is B into T3. So T4 is equal to B into T3. Okay, so the operator is multiplication, argument is B and argument two is T3. So then result will be stored in T4. So then this T5 is equal to T2 plus T4. This T2, T4 are the arguments and plus is the operator and T5 is the result. Okay, so then A is equal to T5. So equal is the operator and T5 will be the argument one and result will be stored in A. So like that we are representing a quadruples. Then when you come to triples, okay, so here in the triples, triple representation, so here we don't have result. The result will be stored in the location, that is position of the string, position of the sub expression. So here operator is equal to unary minus, okay, first one u is t1 is equal to u minus c. So here argument one is c. So this is a triples operator, argument one, argument result we don't have. Okay, so then that one will be stored in the location one. Okay, so in that location one, then next one t2 is equal to b into t1. So t1 is nothing but a location one. Okay, that is the argument two, and b is the argument one, and we are multiplying with, and that result will be stored in location two. Okay, so then in location, when you come to location three, that is u minus c. U minus will be the unary minus will be the operator, and c will be the argument one. That result will be stored in location three. Okay, so then t4 is equal to b into t3. Okay, so result will be b into argument one, and t3 will be the location three. Okay, so those things should be multiplied with operator multiplication. Okay, so then that one result will be stored in location four. Then here t5 is equal to t2 plus t4. That is location two and location four are adding. So that one, this t, that is location two and location four are the arguments of these two things, and adding those two with the operator add plus, and it will be stored in t location five. Okay, so that is nothing but a location five. Then that the content of location five copy to a. The content of location five, so your argument two is nothing but a five, and argument a is equal to one. Argument a, argument one is a, and operator is equal. Okay, so these are the, like that will represents the three address triple representation. Okay, so then last one is indirect triple representation. So here we are using pointer, that's all. Okay, so this is nothing, everything is this is a triple representation, whatever we have discussed, whatever we have discussed this one, okay, same thing we have used. Okay, so triple, so here what we are doing, this statements we are using a indirect address. So that result will be stored in 35 point, this is a pointer. Okay, so the pointer holds the address of statement one, address of statement two, address of statement three, address of statement four, address of statement five, address of statement six. Okay, so here this pointer holds the address of statement one. This is the, that is location one. Okay, so this comes, then when you come to this one, we will have this operator and argument one. So that is nothing but an indirect triple representation. Same thing, so we will have that pointer. Okay, that pointer contains the address of another variable. Pointer is a variable, it holds the address of another variable. So this is the pointer, it holds the address of this location one, like that. This is indirect triple representation. Okay, so this is, you know, representation of triple. Okay, so this is triple representation is very, very important. Okay, so here come to lab program. So this is a theory part of intermediate code representation. So now we will come to a lab program. Design, develop, implement C or Java program to generate the machine code using triples for the statement A is equal to minus B star C plus D, whose intermediate code in three address form. Okay, so this is the expression. Then that intermediate code will be like this. Okay, so t1 is equal to minus b. So here this one minus b, that one will be stored in t1. Then c plus d, that one will be c plus d will be stored in t2. Okay, so then I am adding that minus b star c plus d, that is using t3 is equal to, so t1 and t2, multiplication of t1 and t2, and result will be stored in a. So this is a triple code for this expression. Okay, so write this intermediate code for this. So intermediate code here we are using, you know, assembly level language. Okay, so we already written a lot of things. So in fourth semester, same assembly language we are using here. Okay, so here come to this one. So how will represent in a triple representation? Okay, so here this is the t1 is equal to minus b. Okay, so here we are taking, so minus argument as minus b. Okay, so operator is OP. OP is nothing but a F equal symbol here. Then T2 is equal to C plus D. So C and D are the arguments, and operator is plus, and that result will be stored in location 2. Okay, so this T1 location will be 1. So then after that, what I am multiplying T1 and T2. So that is location 1 and location 2, I am adding, and that one will be stored in location 3. Then content of the location 3 is copied to A. So that is operator is equal to, operator is equal, and content of location 3 will be that result of that expression is copied to A. So this is representation driven. So then how will write the assembly code for this? Okay, so here what you are doing, so here first one is registers, I am writing intermediate code, assembly level language program. So here, so this is the minus B, so this one I need to copy to T1. So I can't directly pass the values from memory to memory. So we need intermediate registers. So here I am using R0 register. So content of that is minus B, I am copy to R0. That assembly law is move is equal to R0 comma minus B. So that content will be copied to R0. From that R0, move T1 comma R0. That is content of R0 will be copied to T1. Okay, I am moving content of R0 to T1. So it means T1 contains the value of minus B. So like that, I need to add C plus D. So directly I can't add two memory locations. So for that, what you need to do? I need to copy that one to register. So that is move R0 comma C. So content of C is copied to R0. Then after that, I am adding content of R0 with D. So content of D, R0 is C. Okay. So I am adding R0 plus D. That is add R0 comma D. So I am adding R0, content of R0 and the content of D, and value, the result is stored in R0 only. Okay. So I have added and result is in R0. Okay. So now I want to, okay, so now I want to copy that R0 content to T2. So that the using this instruction, move T2 comma R0, that content of R0 will be copied to T2. Okay, done, we have written it. Then now I need to multiply the content of that is a T1 and T2. So here that one what I am doing. So here I am copying content of T1 to R0. Okay. So then after that I am multiplying with content of R0. That T1 contains, the R0 contains content of T1. Then the content of T1 is available in R0. R0 will be multiplied with the T2 and result will be stored in R0. Okay. So result will be stored in R0. So then the multiplication result is stored in R0. Now I want to copy that move that content of R0 to T3. So I have added T1 and T2. Okay, I have added T1 and T2 and multiplied T1 and T2 and result will be stored in T3. Okay, so that one I have done the till that. Okay, so now the result of the expression is available in T3. Okay, so then after that, I need to transfer that T3 content to A. How you will transfer? Once again, you need to copy that one to R0, move R0 comma T3. Okay, so move R0 comma T3. So then after that, move A comma R0. That T3 content will be copied to R0. Okay, T3 content will be copied to R0, and R0 content will be copied to A. So now this completes this assembly code of the program. Okay, so for these expressions, we have written assembly. This is the output of your program. Okay, so this is the output of your program. So we need to write this. So this is the input and this is the output of the intermediate code. Okay, so based on this arithmetic expression, we have written the assembly level program. Okay, so this is the output of the program. How we will write that one? Okay, come to program. Okay, so here we are writing a C program. So here ask include stdio.stdlib.h C type. So these are the header files we are using. So here what we are doing, so we are declaring operator. Okay, so then argument 1, argument 2, and result. Okay, so we are declaring these characters arrays. Okay, so then here we are using two files. One is input file, another one is output file. So here in input file, you need to give the input that this triple expression you need to write. So that one will be write like this. Okay, so here you need to write this one in input.txt. So you need to create one input file. Okay, when you are executing, you need to create one input file. So in that you need to write this. Okay, so t1, that is t1 is equal to minus b. So here we are representing like this: t1 space minus b is equal to put question mark. Okay, so because we are using triple things now, so here next argument is not there, that's why we are putting this question mark. Okay, so then t2 is equal to c, that is t2 c plus d. Okay, and t1 star t2. Okay, so this is t1 star t2. Okay, make it t1 star t2. Okay, so t1 star t2 is copy, that result will be copied to t3, and t3 is equal to question mark, because in that way, say we have don't have second operator, you need to write this one in input.txt. Okay, so this is then input f open input.txt for read purpose we are using. Okay, so create that input file. Okay, so then after that we need to open, and we are copy that one to fp1 pointer. Okay, so like that we will have output output.txt, so that is for to write the output. Okay, so that for that we are using fp2 pointer. Okay, so why we need to read the file. Okay, so we need to read the input file. Okay, so in input file what we have, that is first one is result, this is the result. Okay, first one is result we are print. Okay, so we are reading that one. First one is result, next one is argument 1. Okay, so this is argument 1, and next one is operator, and second one is operands. Okay, so this is result, argument, operator, argument. Result, argument 1, operator, argument 2. So that's why we are representing t1 is equal to minus b like this. Okay, so result, argument 1, operator, argument 2. So like that we are representing input, that one we are reading. Okay, so using fscanf function by using fp1 pointer. Okay, so we are read the first one. Okay, suppose if it is operator is plus, what I need to do, if operator is plus, so I need to add two things. Okay, so that is what to add the two memory locations, what I need to do, I need to copy that memory location, that that is argument 1 to the r0. okay, so that assembly code is move r0 comma argument 1. Okay, so here suppose this is the form, you know, assembly code. Okay, so here this is, you know, this is move c plus d is there now, so add c plus d, that is t3 is t2 is equal to t2 is equal to c plus d we have. So that is, this is the code what we have, move r0 comma c, so that one we are doing. So if it is operator plus, the content of argument will be copied to r0, so we are moving r0 comma argument 1, then after that adding r0 comma argument 2. Okay, so that is move r0 comma c. Okay, so we are doing, then after that add r0 comma argument 2, so we are adding those two. Then after that what I am doing, the content of r0 move to, okay, so that is the content of r0 will be moved to t2. Okay, so that one we are doing, that so here move, that is content of that result. Okay, so result comma r0. okay, so we are moving that r0 content to result. Okay, so that is the, if it is a plus operator. Okay, so if it is plus operators, I need to write this code. This intermediate code should come. Okay, so move r0 comma c, so that is if it is argument 1. Okay, so move r0 comma c, then move add r0 comma d, so then move t2 comma result. Okay, that is move result comma r0. Result is nothing but here t2. Okay, so that is the thing we have written. So if it is multiplication, if operator, string compare, if op is operator. Okay, so if operator is multiplication symbol, so then what I need to do, I need to write this code. Okay, okay, so this is, I need to write this code. So that is open in output file you need to write, that is move r0 comma r percentages, that is nothing but argument 1. Move r0 comma argument 1. So that is move r0 comma argument 1 is t1. Okay, so then mul r0 comma argument 2. So argument 2 is nothing but a t2. Okay, so you are multiplying r0 comma t2. So then after result will be stored to r0 to t3. So that is move result comma r0. Okay, percentages comma r0. R0 is percentage s is result. So we are moving r0 content to s, percentage s. Okay, so that percentage s is nothing but a result. That is nothing but a t3 here. Okay, so this is multiplication. Like that, if we have a subtraction, okay, so if our operator is a subtraction symbol, so that is minus. So at that time, so same thing, content of r0, move r0 comma argument 1, the content of argument 1 will be copied to r0 and subtract r0 comma argument 2, and that result will be stored to that r0 result, r0 content will be stored to result. So that is for multiplication, you know, subtraction. Like that, if operator is a division, string, if string compare op is division, so at the time what you need to do, same thing, the move the content of r0 to, sorry, move the r0 argument 1, move r0 comma argument 1, so that is our content of r0 argument 1 copy to r0. So then after that divide r0 comma argument 2. Okay, same thing we have done. Then after that, the result, the content of a result, that is r0 content will be stored to result, that is move percentages comma r0. So percentages is result, move result comma r0, the content of r0 is stored to result. Okay, if it is division. Okay, but in that expression only we have plus and multiplication. Okay, so these things, these two things are not executing. Okay, because we are having only a plus and multiplication, but you need to write that whole program. Okay, so then last one is equal symbol. If operator is equal, so what we need to do, if operator is equals, we need to copy that right side content to left side. So how we will write? So for that we will use intermediate register r0 once again. So move r0 comma argument, these two things, for these two, so move r0 comma minus b and these two things. Okay, move r0 comma t3. Okay, so these things I am doing here. F print f, that is f to or write out in output file. So move r0 comma percentage s, that is r0 percentage s is nothing but here minus b, or here it may be t3. Okay, so then I copied that argument content to r0. So then that one, that r0 content should be stored in result. Okay, so move percentages is nothing but move result comma r0. Okay, so here result comma r0, so the content of r0 will be copied to a result t. Okay, so I have copied that right side content to left side. Okay, so using intermediate register, r0 register. Then after that we are closing the input file and we are closing output file. That's all. That is the program. Now we will come to execution part. Okay, Megeshwari madam will take that execution part. Wait for a minute.
Good afternoon all. I'll be showing the execution of the program which sir explained now. Okay. So I'm using the same platform, that is D++. Okay, so I've just created a file with the code whatever sir explained. Okay, that is C program. So I've included all the things where file pointer is required, and all the lines I have written here. Okay, so extension of save it with the extension .c. Okay, one second, I'll just share the screen. Yeah, so I'm using Dave C platform, and I've copied the complete code. Okay, and I've saved the file in the name. Since this is fifth program, I have named it as phi.c. Okay, and in the program, you need to create a text file, right? That is name is input.txt. So I've created input.txt here, and I've included whatever the input you're supposed to give. Okay, so while even you all while executing this program, you have to enter the input in the same way. Wherever the space is required, you have to write it in the same way. Okay, so I've created this, and I'll directly go to the execution part. Okay. So you have to come to the you have to change the path. Okay, so I'm in the path like desktop assist lab. So here I have saved the program assist lab. Okay, so now I'll be executing this code using gcc command. Okay, this is C compiler, right? So gcc space phi.c file name. It was executed. So now execute output file, that is a.exe, enter. Okay, so now you have to check whatever the input you have given for this thing, have you got the output, that is output.txt. So what I'll do after executing this, I'll display the output file. The command here I'm using is type space file name, that is output.txt. Okay, so when you press enter, you can see the output here. Okay, so the same thing you can do it in Ubuntu or in Fedora as well. Okay, so this is all about the execution.